Hi, great good morning to you all. I, Sumit Kumar Singh, welcome all of you in Magath Putra Dream IAS YouTube channel. My dear friends, today in this video, we are going to read, revise and recall the UPSC Civil Services Mains Examination Question Paper of previous year 2016. So, it is the General Studies Paper 2, General Studies Paper 2 of 2016. So, in a series of previous year question, we are going to only read, not going to any analysis or any discussions. We only going to read to revise and recall the previous year questions so that we be able to identify the important areas, the way of asking questions, the pattern of UPSC, on which pattern the UPSC generally asks the question, on which important areas they identify, so that in the future preparation, be able to strategize our preparation or make a strategy so that we will got a good marks. Time allotted 3 hours and 250 marks. First, we will read the question paper specific instructions. Please read each of the following instructions carefully before attempting questions. There are 20 questions printed both in Hindi and in English. All questions are compulsory. The number of marks carried by a question part is indicated against it. Answers must be written in the medium authorized in the admission certificate, which must be stated clearly on the cover of the question come answer QCA booklet in the space provided. No marks will be given for answers written in a medium other than the authorized one. Word limits in questions wherever specified should be adhered to. Any page or portion of the page left blank in the question come answer booklet must be clearly struck off. Now, question, all the questions in not more than 200 words. So there is a word limitations is 200. And content of the answer is more important than its length. One of the most important point here to note. The content of the answers are more important than its length. All questions carry equal marks. 12 and half into 20, 250. It means each questions carry 12 and half marks. Now, question number 1. We will read the question number 1. Discuss the essential of 69th. Constitutional Amendment Act and anomalies, if any, that have led to recent reported conflict between the elected representative and the institution of the Lieutenant Governor in the administration of Delhi. Do you think that this will give rise to a new trend in the functioning of the Indian federal politics? Now, question number 2. To what extent is Article 370 of the Indian Constitution bearing marginal note, temporary provision with respect to the state of Jammu and Kashmir, temporary? Discuss the future prospects of this provision in the context of Indian polity. Question number 3. The Indian party system is passing through a phase of transition which looks to be full of contradictions and paradoxes. Discuss. Question number 4. Exercise of CAG's power in relation to the account of the union and the state is derived from the Article 149 of the Indian Constitution. Discuss whether audit of the government's policy implementation could amount to overstepping its own CAG jurisdiction. Now, question number 5. Discuss each adjective attached to the word republic in the preamble. Are they defendable in the present circumstances? Now, question number 6. What are held in the Coelho case? Coelho case. In this context, you can say that judicial review is of key importance among the basic feature of the constitution. Now, question number 7. Did the Government of India Act 1935 lays down a federal constitution? Discuss. Now, क्वेश्चन नंबर 8, व्हाट इज द क्वासी जुडिशियल बॉडी, एक्सप्लेन विद द हेल्प ऑफ कंक्रीट एग्जांपल्स। क्वेश्चन नंबर 9, प्रोफेसर अमर्त्या सेन हैज एडवोकेटेड इंपॉर्टेंट रिफॉर्म इन द रिलम्स ऑफ प्राइमरी एजुकेशन एंड प्राइमरी हेल्थ केयर, व्हाट आर योर सजेशंस टू इंप्रूव देयर स्टेटस एंड परफॉर्मेंस। क्वेश्चन नंबर 10, इन द इंडियन गवर्नेंस सिस्टम द रोल ऑफ नॉन स्टेट एक्टर्स हैज बीन ओनली मार्जिनल, क्रिटिकली एग्जामिन दिस स्टेटमेंट। क्वेश्चन नंबर 11, इफेक्टिवनेस ऑफ द गवर्नमेंट सिस्टम एट वेरियस लेवल्स एंड द पीपल्स पार्टिसिपेशन इन द गवर्नेंस सिस्टम आर इंटरडिपेंडेंट, डिस्कस देयर रिलेशनशिप इन द कॉन्टेक्स्ट ऑफ इंडिया। नाउ क्वेश्चन नंबर 12, In the Integrity Index of Transparency International, India stands very low. Discuss briefly the legal, political and economical, social and cultural factors that have caused the decline of public morality in India. Question number 13, has the Indian governmental system responded adequately to the demands of liberalization, privatization and globalization started in 1991? What can the government do to be responsive to this important change? Question number 14. Traditional bureaucratic structure and culture have hampered the process of socio-economic development in India. Comment. Question number 15. Examine the main provisions of the National Child Policy and throw light on the status of its implementation. Question number 16. Demographic dividend in India will remain only theoretical unless our manpower becomes more educated, aware, skilled and creative. What measures have been taken by the government to enhance the capacity of our population to be more productive and employable? Now, question number 17. The broader aims and objectives of WTO are to manage and promote international trade in the era of globalization. But the Doha round of negotiations seemed doomed due to differences between the developed and the developing countries, discussed in the Indian perspective. Now, question number 18. Evaluate the economic and strategic dimensions of India's locust policy in the context of the post-Cold War international scenario. Question number 19. Increasing cross-border terrorist attack in India and growing interference in the internal affairs of several member states by Pakistan are not conducive for the future of SAARC, South Asian Association for Regional Cooperation. Explain with suitable examples. Question number 20. What are the aim and objectives of the MC Bright Commission of the UNESCO? What is India's position on these? So, today in this video, we had looked the General Studies Paper 2, General Studies Paper 2, Civil Services, Mains 2016. Today in this video, or the purpose of this video, to only read, revise and recall the previous year question, the pattern of asking by the UPSC, Public Commission. So, if you are the first time on my channel, then like it, share it and subscribe it. Thank you. Have a great day.